This video is all about the ratios of the measures of similar figures. Now, similar figures have the same shape but a different size. Their angles are all congruent, but their sides are going to be proportional. Let's see what that means. Let's say we have a rectangular prism, and it has a length of 1 and a width of 2. If we double the length and double the width and double the height, we're going to get a similar figure. Okay, twice as wide, twice as long, and twice as tall. It's going to have the same shape, just a different size. Let's look at the ratios, the relationships between the measures. Well, looking at the lengths, length is one-dimensional, just like width and height. That ratio here is going to be 1 to 2. All of the lengths are twice as long in the bigger figure. The area is going to be two-dimensional, and the ratio of the areas is 1 to 4. Look at the front face. In the little one, it's 1 square, and in the on the right, on the larger figure, it's going to be 4 squares. There's 4 times as many little squares. Now, the volume is 3-dimensional. It's going to have a ratio of 1 to 8. There's 8 times as many cubes in the larger figure. I mean, just remember how it was before. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There's going to be 8 times as many cubes. Well, here's the big idea. The length, you can call that ratio A to B, 1-dimensional. Area is that number squared, A squared to B squared, and volume is A cubed to B cubed. Let's do another example. This time, let's go ahead and make it 3 times as long and wide and tall. The ratio of our lengths is going to be 1 to 3. And then for the area, it's 1 squared to 3 squared, 1 to 9. Notice there's 9 squares where before there are only 1 in the front. And the volume is 1 to 27. It's a lot more. How would this go in the real world? Let's see. Let's say a pharaoh made a pyramid and it was 100 meters wide. And the next pharaoh said, I want mine to be twice as big. It will have twice the length. Is that going to be twice as big? How much bigger is it going to be? Well, let's say that the first one was made with 5,000 stones. I'm not saying they're going to be cubic meters or anything, just 5,000 stones. That's how many stones that will fill it up. How many stones will it take to make the new pyramid? Well, let's first look at the ratios, the relationship between their lengths. It's 100 to 200. You can treat them just like fractions. Divide by 100, divide by 100. And the relationship is 1 to 2. The second one is twice as long. All of the measures of lengths are going to be in a ratio of 1 to 2. The height, the lateral edge, all of the little one-dimensional measures. The areas are going to be 1 squared to 2 squared, 1 to 4. The area of the base, the area of those triangles, they're all going to have a ratio of 1 to 4, and volume will be 1 to 8, 1 cubed to 2 cubed. 2 times 2 times 2 is 8. So let's do the actual problem. Let's work out the proportion. 5,000 stones for the little one. How many stones? What about the volume of the big one? We'll go ahead and write down the ratios. The volume is going to have a ratio of 1 to 8, little one to big one. So 5,000 for the little one is to, I don't know, x is to the big one. 1 is to 8 is 5,000 is to x. And you can write that as a proportion. 1 over 5,000 equals 8 over x. If you have two ratios or two fractions that are equal to each other, that's called a proportion, and you just cross multiply. 8 times 5,000 is 40,000. 1 times x is x. You're done. That's your answer. 40,000 stones. Let's see if we can set it up a different way. Remember, 1 to 8, a ratio, can be written just as a fraction. 1 to 8. 1 over 8. And that's small 1 over big 1. So make sure your other fraction is also going to be small one over big one. 5,000 stones over I don't know how many stones. Again, you just cross multiply. 8 times 5,000 is 40,000 stones. And x times 1 is going to be x. So remember, with all problems like this, A and B make that the ratio of the lengths of anything one-dimensional, square them for the ratio of area, and cube them for the ratio of the volumes.